So Warner Brothers fails yet again, and hilariously enough, they did this right after going out and going after the fans, telling them what they want, that doesn't matter. Here's a novel concept. Maybe when you're doing public relations tours, telling people to endorse your movie, maybe you shouldn't tell them that they don't matter and hey, you don't need them at all. Now, I remember a time when insulting your consumers when you're trying to open a movie, that was practically unheard of. Every now and then, you might have somebody do it. They were considered crazy, though. But these days, companies like Warner Brothers, they sign off on this stuff. You have producers of movies like Suicide Squad, Aquaman 2, that's the same guy here, by the way, going out and blasting the very people that are supposed to open their wallets. And guess how that goes? It doesn't go well at all. Now, as far as Suicide Squad, I actually like this movie. I thought it was enjoyable. In fact, a lot of YouTubers that say they don't like it, they sound more like critics than customers wanting to go and see a popcorn flick. And yet, when you look at the numbers here, well, these, they are underwhelming and then some. I mean, you have a movie here that lowball conservative estimates were saying that that was going to come in at least $30 million. Well, guess what? It didn't come in close to that. It comes in $26,205,415 and counting. After adding in the international box office, it's almost at $45 million right now. You have a worldwide box office of $71,183,341. And remember, this is only a popularity gauge. This isn't profitability. In international markets, you get about 45%. Domestic used to be 65%. Now it's much, much lower. And when you start looking into the costs of making this movie, well, the production budget alone comes in at a whopping $175 million. Talking about advertisement, that usually doubles this number. So just to break even, you're talking about $350 million. You can't have too many paltry weekends and really survive that. Now, the media, they do what the media does best. They look at the movie, they examine all the facts, and then they point the finger every single place except where the finger should be pointed, and that's squarely at the companies. In this case, it should be squarely pointed at Warner Brothers. Now, let me be clear about this. I'm not saying what they noted here doesn't have an impact on film. As far as the beer bug goes, I know there's a lot of people that still don't want to go out. HBO Max, it definitely does give people the option to stay at home. That will cut into the profitabilities, considering people can just pay $15. They can sit in their house. And the name here, Suicide Squad versus The Suicide Squad, yeah, that wasn't a good creative decision at all. A problem that the media would never ever point out, though, and that Warner would never allow them to point out, is the fact that they've been attacking customers. They've been saying all kinds of things like, they don't matter, we don't have to listen to what they want. And they were doing this while they were talking about the Suicide Squad, saying, hey, this thing is coming in a week. By the way, you folks, you don't matter at all. See, if you really want to know what hurts this movie and the media they won't tell you about, well, look no further than articles like this. See, this guy here, Peter Safran, the Aquaman 2 producer, he's also the Suicide Squad producer, and he came out. He talked about fans. He talked about fan pressure and not removing a certain nameless person, saying that we as a company never considered listening to that fan pressure. Again, hey, by the way, we're doing this during the Suicide Squad when we're talking about it. That, though, that's not going to affect the bottom line in any way whatsoever. Oh, genius, isn't it? Now, if you're like me, you want to know where all of this stuff comes from. And it hails from the Hero Nation podcast. Never heard of it, by the way? Well, you're in good company. I'd never heard of it, too. But this, it's brought to you by Deadline.com. They're a shill for a certain nameless person. That's how these conversations, they get shoehorned in. But you have Peter Safran. He's supposed to be talking about the UK premiere of Warner Brothers Suicide Squad. He's supposed to be talking about James Gunn, Idris Elba. Basically, he's supposed to be hyping this stuff up. But during all of that, he has that certain nameless person come up. And when you look at the way that this comes up, it isn't just what's said that's really insulting. It's what's happening between the lines. I mean, you see the quotes here. And look at this. Said Safran, who's James Gunn, the Suicide Squad movie, hits theaters and HBO Max on August 6th. Again, they're wanting you to buy a movie while telling you that they don't care what you think. So I don't think we're ever going to react to, honestly, pure fan pressure. You got to do what's best for the movie. We felt that if it's James Wan and Jason Momoa, it should be a certain nameless person. That's really what it was. One is not unaware of what is going on in the Twitterverse, but that doesn't mean you have to react to it or take it as gospel or accede to their wishes. You have to do what is right for the film, and that's really where we landed on it. Now, let's omit for a second that this guy, he just said that 1.859 million people plus, this is just one page, by the way, but these folks, they don't matter. They don't influence anybody. They don't buy tickets. That fan pressure right there, yeah, it's just a bunch of noise on Twitter. Let's omit that for a second. Instead, I want you to really focus on what this guy is saying here, remembering again that Warner Brothers, they're okay with this message, this stuff. This is what happened behind the scenes. He's basically just telling you the truth about the way they see it. And what they see this as is a bunch of noise out here from millions of people that, number one, they can't impact Aquaman 2. Number two, they can't impact Suicide Squad as well. Yeah, they thought that the customers, they don't matter. The only people that matter are the Peter Safrans, the David Wans, the Jason Momoas, that certain nameless person. Those folks, they matter and nothing else. Now, color me foolish or naive or even conspiratorial, but I'm going to say that it wasn't review bombing that caused this. It wasn't the reviews themselves that caused this. It wasn't the beer bug. It wasn't HBO Max. It wasn't the fact that they took the title of the last one and they added the in front of it. It was that stuff, plus the fact that they chose to denigrate the consumers. That stuff, it made headlines. Them saying, you can't hurt us at all. And the consumers saying, you know what? Let's see about that. Game on, baby. Game on indeed. But anyway, you let me know what you think about this. I'm curious. They take a good movie, they basically make it fail. I wonder how that happens. Oh man, it's not science, is it? But anyway, let me know what you think. If you want to help out the channel, links are in the description. I appreciate the heck out of you folks too. They don't want to appreciate you, that's fine. Move over here. We appreciate the heck out of you. We can always use your help too. Check out our stuff. But yeah, you being here, it matters. So thank you. Appreciate you. See you soon.